Hi, I'm EC Strange, and this is Bad Movie Show, episode 77, the Japanese Show 2. And tonight's a very special episode. We are here with one of my favorite guys in the universe, my friend JP. Say hi, JP.
Hello.
And if you watch this show, you know he's my man. He has recommended many of the movies that we review. Recommended Man Board, and I talked about it with him. So I said, hey, want to do a show with me? And he said,
absolutely.
I said, what kind of show do you want to do? And he said,
Japanese horror.
And I said, fuck yeah. Well, we're doing it here tonight at our favorite bar, Lucky 13 on 644 Sackett
Street.
Street. Between 3rd and 4th Avenue here in Brooklyn, USA. And we're very excited, aren't you?
Absolutely excited.
Yeah! So why don't we get started at the top with Vampire Girl versus Frankenstein Girl, not rated, 2009 Funimation Films. Written by, have patience, people, Naoki Tamatsu. Directed by Naoki Tamatsu and Yoshihiro Nishimura. Oh, dude. That was some good stuff. Ready? Starring Yuki Karamura, Takumi Sato, Eli Otoguro, and Ishi Shihina. I'm proud of this, yo. Aren't you proud of me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, ready?
Nailed it.
All right. So, Valentine's Day, and we have two girls, Keiku and Minami, and they both like the same boy, Jugon, okay? And Minami gives Jugon a piece of chocolate with her blood in it, not telling him that she happens to be a vampire, and he turns into a half vampire. Now Keiko watches this going on, and she's not having it. And after watching them kiss, freaks out and ends up falling off of the roof. Now what we're not telling you is that her father, the assistant principal, who's like this like geeky kind of like henpecked kind of teacher, is actually a psychopath, mad scientist, killing the students and experimenting on their body parts, pulling them apart. After his daughter dies, he collects the body parts and puts them together, creating something completely different, giving our girl, Minami, a hard time trying to get her man. So, JP, what do you think?
Well, I enjoy a lot about this movie. One of the things I enjoyed with the high school groups is they had these three different clubs. They had the Cutters, the Lolitas, and the Super Tan Club.
Super tan club.
It's
fucked up.
Yeah, that was little
racist.
Little bit.
Super racist. Let's put it this way, honey. If it was anybody but the Japanese, they'd be like protesting about this movie. But we're gonna let it go because it's Japanese. And they love them to black people, and they did it kind of cute. But if it was an American movie, this would have been a protest on it. It's very racist.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. One thing I also enjoyed is during a lot of the kill scenes, is very, very upbeat music. You know, really happy music. And oh yeah, by the way, someone's just getting brutally murdered.
Yes, with the raining down blood and she's like dancing and every lip.
Yeah.
We love a bloody fucking Japanese schoolgirl moment.
It just is a great thing that especially with this movie, with the style of the movie, you see the 20 gallons of blood for, oh God, I got a paper cut and spray.
Yes!
Love the spray.
So great.
Yo, JP, on a scale from 1 to 5, what do you give this movie?
This one, I gave a 3.75.
3.75,
oh, okay.
You get technical on you.
Wow.
That's right.
Yes.
Also, there was a kill count of 20 in this movie.
Dude, he's not messing rap.
Man comes with a kill count.
Kill count.
To be fair, some of those are recycled kills.
No, it's okay.
So
blood is blood.
It's a fun one.
All right. Well, I'm giving this movie a 4.5. It is messed up and fun as fuck. So I say 4.5 and a buy it. Vampire Girl versus Frankenstein Girl. It's messed up as fuck, so get ready. It's very racist and like, but we love it for that. It's very trauma-like for a Japanese movie, and we love it for that even more. So next up, you ready?
Oh, absolutely.
All right, we got Robo Geisha 2009, not rated Funimation Films. Written and directed by Noro Iguchi, starring Asami Sugura, Ayaki Gucci, and Takumi Saito. I was much better with these because I've said these things before. Proud of me?
Very
Let's
proud.
Let's get started, okay? So we have Yoshi, who is the abused and very timid sister of Kikuyako.
Nailed that one.
Who is a beautiful, glamorous geisha who is very mean and selfish. So they get invited by Hikaru Kagano, who is the president of Kagano Steel Manufacturing, to go to his house and have dinner. And while they're there, he talks Yoshi into becoming part of his hidden geisha, like his crazy geisha girl assassin's crew. And meanwhile, Kikuyaku ends up doing the dishes and the laundry until she gets fed up and says, fuck that, I'm gonna move up in the ranks, and becomes the squad's executioner and moves up. Now, when you move up in the ranks, you get the right to get, what, physically modified?
Augmented.
Honey, she gets a machine gun out of her boob and starts killing people with it. So now you have the two sisters and they're trying to out-modify each other, which ends up crazy because they have armpit swords, butt stars, honey, we go on. Until our girl Yoshi becomes the formidable assassin and becomes Robo Geisha. Gets sent out on a whole bunch of kills until Mr. Kagano tells her to go and kill some family members of his already geishas, and she turns around going, this isn't right, and tries to save the day before he turns his crazy castle into a robot with a nuclear weapon and totally destroys Japan. Yo, JP.
The building robot was a surprise.
Oh my god! We all need a breakdancing robot with a nuclear weapon around its neck like a fucking clock chain in our lives.
Trying to drop the bomb into Mount Fuji.
He's dropping the bomb! Oh.
This movie was, I love this movie. And I remember even talking about, this is the first movie I suggested.
Yes.
For this.
Yes.
And
yes.
The way I sold it was, I said, you know what? Two words, butt swords.
Butt swords. We fucking bought it the next day. Hon, tell me butt swords. I'm buying a movie. buying a movie.
I love it because three girls have butt swords.
Yes.
And don't look, I'm so embarrassed. They're trying to kill each other. Don't look, I'm so embarrassed. Fantastic.
Oh, and I'm up to get from 1 to 5. Did you give it?
This got a 4.25.
Woo!
I'm very harsh on movies.
Another technical
number. I love this movie.
4.25, Todd.
I love
He's
this
ecstatic.
Movie.
He's ecstatic. You ready to make?
Oh, go for it.
Okay. This is crazy, gory, psychotic, goofy, silly, and yet has a very heartwarming story about sisters. This is sick as fuck. I'm giving it a 5. Okay? Between the goofiness and the serious story about sisters, it is just hit the 5s for me. I'm saying buy it. And we love this. This is great. My girl turns into a tank and she goes to fucking get her sister to save the day. So we love this. Yes. 5. And if I spoke Japanese, I'd probably be excited, but I don't. So I say fuck.
Also, kill count of 40. Yeah, we got the
kill count. Yeah, it's 40. He's not messing around. Dude, it isn't getting point and decimals and all of that with the movie. So
also,
we love JP.
The buildings bleed.
Oh my god!
Buildings bleed. Not just people, not just robots. Buildings.
I love that part.
Buildings spraying blood.
I love that. If a building was filled with people and a robot cut it in half, would it bleed?
I don't know if it's spraying
blood. I don't care. You know what? They got the Japanese. I don't give a fuck. I don't need an explanation. Bleeding. Buildings, yes. We love it. And we will go on. Ready, JK?
Always.
Last, certainly not least, we have Japanese Princess Unrated 2009, Welgo USA Incorporated, screenplay by Satoru Hayashi, story and directed by Kengo Kaji, starring Eino Kishi, Dai Mizuno, Azuku Tadaka, and Mao Shino. I'm rocking these Japanese names tonight, and I have cocktails, honey, so we say, you ready? Okay, so after 11 girls are attacked, savagely raped, and cut into pieces, a Buddhist nun and a mad scientist find a girl up living amongst these pieces. They put her together with the girls, and the Buddhist nun put the souls of all 11 girls into this one being that called themselves the Samurai Princess. Now they meet a guy named Gekko, who used to be a mecha hunter. Now a mecha is the synthetic, mechanized people that the Samurai Princess is, and he
like Frankenstein peeps.
Kind of Frankenstein peeps. And he has a mechanized hand, and he meets her in the Infinity Woods, and they set out to go and meet up with this fucking mad scientist, Karako, who killed his sister. Anyway, there are these two crazy mechanized artist psychos that are tearing people into pieces and making them into art. And our samurai princess and her boy Gekko will stop at nothing to tear them all to pieces and send them to justice. So, JP, what do you got to say about this?
Well, I enjoyed Gekko's furry guitar. I thought that was amazing.
Dude,
he had a furry guitar.
He plays a monster guitar with his mechanized hands, and tornadoes come out. So, yes, we love that.
It's just the various assortment of strange weapons in this movie. I enjoyed when the young lady took her boobs off and used them as a weapon.
Yes!
I love
that.
We
love that too.
Amazing. I enjoyed the a lot of the humor that it had. It was very it was very off kilter for especially even a movie like this. It was definitely definitely different than some of the other ones where they just focus on, it's a revenge story.
I remember it to be very serious for this kind of tough in this film.
I enjoyed that it was different than a lot of them, and which is great. I thought it was fantastic. The kill count is 26.
Uh-huh.
I need to have that.
Yes, I love your kill count.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And this one also got a 3.75, because I love my points.
Oh no, I'm gonna let you do that 3.745 because that's just fucking fresh, okay? You ready for me?
Do it.
I'm gonna say that this is like the Chainsaw Sally of fucking independent horror shock action Japanese films. Not only are the girls all wearing stripes and have their hair in crazy ponytails, but this is like all in the woods with some like really ghetto fucking blood and like just some crazy ass stuff. they saved all the money for the end with the crazy ass two-faced monster, and I love that. I'm gonna give this a 4.5 and a C. I love where they put their money. I love the attention to detail.
Very smart with the budget.
I love that my girl is all hodgepodge with the costume. But if you think about it, it's all the clothes of the 11 girls that were brutally raped and torn apart put into her costume. I love the attention to detail. Yes, 4.5 and a C. See it.
Definitely see it.
And this is, it has a very sexy and very real feel sexy that I have to say.
Wow, chicka, wow, wow.
So we're gonna give it a hell yes, 4.5. See it. We love the Japanese films. And yeah.
Love. All right, I'm gonna try to butcher a name now. Yoshihiro Nishimura did effects for all of these movies. He is considered the Tom Savini of Japan.
All right.
Yeah.
And that's why a lot of these have a similar look and tone when it comes to especially the gore and even just the general look in practical effects. Just a fun thing that I found out researching for this.
Yes, and we love that.